I just got back from hunting figures. Shopping bags, crazy finds, bitches. Feel just called, gotta pick up figures. I sell the extras for my cage flipping. Future waves, I will be copping. Come check with me, you know I got it. Devil's Duel's not a scalper, people. Figure arts, Marvel Legends. Dudes doing the reviews, fellas. Do keep getting that dinero copping. Even if I got a review to sell it, even got comic shop credit. Lucky, look, I found it. They call me Devil's Duel. Watch the review, yo. You know I got it. It's your boy, Devil's Duel. And you know I got it. So subscribe.
What's going on? It's your boy Devil's Duel. Today we're doing another action figure review. Today we're going to be doing shit. WWE Elite Mattel, WWE Elite 32, The Rock. This is actually going to be a comparative review. We also will be taking a look at Elite 16. If you smell what The Rock is cooking. And I got to say, I got the Elite 32 from my man James Alexander, and I got the Elite 16 Luth from ringsidecollectibles.com for like $4. So since I was there, I was like, yeah, I'm going to purchase some more stuff. So I got the Legends Warrior, the Legends Ultimate Warrior WWE Championship, the yellow strap, the tag titles now, and a ladder, and some other stuff, and then that's it. And then I got these also for like $3. I got the Team Bring It each. I got the Brahma Red Bull, and I got the U.S. Flag Bull. Now, looking at these two guys, I already see differences in the body. Elite 16 Rock is a bit slimmer than the new Elite 32. The Elite 32 got the Ultimate Warrior Triple H body mold on, where the Rock has, I think, Stone Cold. And I'm kind of disappointed because The Rock was filming G.I. Joe during this look right here. Or I believe G.I. Joe or Fast and the Furious. And that's the biggest he's been at that point in time. And he should have the same body mold as the Elite 32 Rock. So I'm kind of mad about that. And he has the finished tattoo. This Rock right here, The face scan is spot on. Spot on. The haircut is spot on. This is before he went full bald. He finally gave up. It comes with his guitar. He comes with the removable pants. He does have trunks under, of course. And he comes with the new logo WWE microphone, which is kind of a mess up because when he did this appearance, it was in Sacramento, and he was talking shit about how the Sacramento Kings never win a championship, and the Heat always spank them or not. The guitar is a breakable one, so when you hit a toy with it, the stem breaks off and the back of the guitar breaks into two. Elite 16 Rock, I don't remember where he came. I think he came with sunglasses and one of those shirts that I showed, but that's why I bought the three. I wasn't sure. And I was happy I picked him up. I'm done with The Rock now. I have the Rocky Maivia, thanks to Alfonso. I have the Elite 16 Rock, which is my favorite look. And now I have this Elite 32 Flashback Rock. So I'm pretty much done with The Rock. Unless it's a nice... I kind of did want the Legends one, but I missed out. He used to wear them ugly-ass Versace shirts. The Versace-style shirts. But it is what it is. But anyway, I do like this figure. The new one. We already know how I feel about this. So, I'm going to put him off back then. I really do like this figure, man. I'm I'm mad that they made this one bulkier than the Elite 16 because this was like a bit after he left the WWE the first time. I mean, his last time. And he wasn't that big when he left. If anything, this figure should have that body mold and that figure should have this body mold. But again, I'm not sweating it. It's not a big deal. Either way, they both are the same size. It's just Elite 16 is less muscular. I love this head scan, yo. I can't get enough of it. It's a lot better than the Elite 16 one. It's beautiful, baby. Got his smile. I like how they did the paint job. Even though I think the fade should be a little bit lower back here. Yeah, it's a little bit uneven. I love the face scan. Got the smile spot on. The Brahma Bull tattoo, yeah. The Samoan tribal tattoo. Not finished, because as we know, he does have it on the chest piece on Elite 16 now. Really like this figure, man. His articulation, standing up, down, side to side, ball joint shoulder, bicep swivel, single jointed elbow, wrist swivel, and his hinge, so he goes back and forward. He has a beautiful ab crunch, waist swivel. His legs go out that much. He got a thigh cut swivel, double jointed knee. He got boot rotation, but the style of his boots kind of block it from doing it. And his ankle pivots down and forward, as you can see here, but I don't like doing it because I'm scared I'm going to break them. I do love this figure. I do recommend this figure. He is the must-get. Him and Rey Mysterio, to me, is the must-get. Lex Luger, too, but I'm not getting him. I'm not a big fan of Lex Luger after what he did. The way he walked out on WWE. Yeah. But anyway, Elite 16 Rock. The head scan's okay. Not the best. His goatee is on wrong. The tattoo is spot on. Very nicely detailed. They did a great job. Brahma Bull. Here, the Brahma Bull got red eyes. The other one doesn't. I don't know why. And then he got the Brahma Bull trunks. Front and back. This one says The Rock on it. And articulation is the same. His head goes up that much. Doesn't go down. Side to side. Ball jointed shoulder. Bicep swivel. Single jointed elbow. Wrist swivel. Hinge. So he goes forward back. He got an ab crunch. Waist swivel. His legs go out that much. Thigh swivel. Double jointed knee. Boot rotation. Again, see the boot blocks it. The strap on the top. And his ankle goes down and up. Now, any wrestling fan knows you're supposed to get The Rock. You gotta have a Rock in your collection. I have three Rocks. Past, present, and past, present. Well, if you want to... Yeah, we have past, present, future. I hope they make a Rock figure like the way he came out in Brooklyn. When Raw was here, the night he made fun of Lana and Rusev. That'd be dope. But... Word. Again, gotta have a Rock. I highly recommend both of these guys. I think the Elite 16 is the best one. I don't like the other. I forgot what Elite that is. It's the same Rock without the goatee. I don't like that one. That's why I got this one. But out of all the Rocks that I own, this one's the best. The new one, Elite 32. So pick them up. Ringside Collectibles, $4.50. You cannot go wrong for an Elite. It's loose. And some of them might have paint issues, but you can't go wrong. Just touch it up yourself. Buy some acrylic paint, a nice matte drying clear coat, and you're really good, man. You ain't no big deal. So, pick it up. If not, that's on you. Don't miss out on these bad boys. If you smell what the dude is cooking. That's the review. Hit the like button if you're feeling it. Leave a comment. Subscribe if you haven't. Follow my Twitter, Instagram. Like my Facebook page. Holler at me in general, people. You already know. Check with me. You know I got it. One.